I knew pretty much that I wanted to be a teacher. My mom was a teacher, and her mother was a teacher. My sister teaches as well. So, and then at the school that I attended, on if you had study hall, you were allowed to volunteer in classrooms, and so I always did that.
Shifting into English, my original certification was dance, 7 through 12, and I taught dance in the private and public sector, but I've always had a passion for reading. I was an avid reader, and falling into English was something that just kind of naturally progressed as I fell more in love with language and more in love with books, and got to a point where I wanted to make young people fall in love with language and fall in love with books. And so being an English teacher was a very organic result of that desire.
So from kindergarten on, I always said I wanted to be a teacher. My mom teaches, and my grandfather's sisters were all teachers, so it just kind of comes naturally.
The hugs that you get every day, the excitement that I feel when they know the information on a Wednesday and they remembered it on Thursday. It's exciting to see the growth that they have day to day.
The middle college students have a common goal. They all want to move on to college. As opposed to a more traditional school, you may have a classroom of 30 students and 15 of these students want to go to college and 5 of these students want to go into diesel mechanics and 6 students over here want to be welders. And then this group up here, they're not really sure and they're undecided. So you're teaching to just such a broad spectrum. It does make it challenging. And in the middle college, they all have that common goal of wanting to go to college. That is their goal. So you have an opportunity to go deeper into instruction because they've already decided this is relevant. This is the path I want to take. I want to push myself harder, and so I want to be challenged. So here I am. Challenge me.
We have a little bit of a different spin here at Northeast in that I have a lot of robotics background and equipment. And so this particular class and several of my others are geared toward looking at STEM through robotics. My competition teams have been extremely competitive to the point where we've actually made it to worlds or international level competitions multiple times. We have a group this year that is going to be traveling to California to compete at the North American International Invitational. So they'll get to be competing with about 75, 80 teams from across the globe. It keeps our kids globally competitive. And that's part of the goal of keeping the program going, is to make our district and to make the kids in our district more globally competitive across the board.
Sometimes you feel like when you teach pre-K, everybody just thinks, oh, she's just got the little people, you know, but it was just nice to see, to be able to represent pre-K even, just to show we do a lot in here, even though it might not look like it. We are giving the kids what they need in order to be successful in kindergarten.
I think that all teachers put our heart and soul into this. Teaching is not a job where you go home at night and you leave everything in the building. I would venture to say teaching is one of the only professions where you spend a lot of time worrying about other people's children. So to have that work ethic recognized by the county, I think is very humbling, because I know there are a lot of teachers in this county that put in the hours and the time and the effort with all of their students. But it was very exciting to see that all of that work, I guess, that has been done over the years was recognized, just like any person likes to be recognized for their efforts.
It's been a little difficult because I kind of feel like there's so many incredible teachers in my building who work just as hard as I do every single day. And so I'm humbled by the fact that I was chosen for this. It's something that's kind of hard to put into words.